not enough to just say x is 61. Okay, we're going to write an equation to solve for x. So what equation can we write that x would be the solution?
62 plus 57 equals x.
No.
It's 180 minus 62 minus 6 minus 57 equals
80 minus 62 minus 57 equals x. Is that true?
No.
Good, Zach.
It's 180
minus 62
plus 57
equals x.
Yet another one.
It's the exact same except you put parentheses around the 62 plus 57.
So you have this one. Like that?
Yeah.
Okay. Gianna?
Okay. I just 67 plus.
67, 62?
Or 62, it looks like a 67. Plus 57 minus 180. Equals x.
What sort of variety is your card?
It is 62 plus 57 plus x equals 180.
Okay. Any others? We've got a bunch here. They could be all right. That's one thing we should realize. It's not like there's only one equation that would work. Okay.
There's two
that are correct.
Carter's and Kale's.
Zach says Carter's is correct. And whose?
Kayla's.
Okay, which one is that? This one is parentheses. This one is yours, Zach. Is that one not right?
I didn't put the parentheses.
So you would agree that parentheses are needed?
Yes.
Okay, so the parentheses, why are parentheses necessary? Emma?
I have an answer. Instead of doing parentheses, the one on the bottom could be correct because it's the same thing. Because the adding comes first.
This one could be correct?
Yeah, because it's the same.
Okay. Well, let's just start. Let's go back to that question of why are the parentheses necessary? Do you have a question or an answer to that, Dalton?
No.
Why the parentheses are necessary? I want to know why the parentheses are necessary here. Yes.
So we know that we have to do the 62 plus 57.
Or 62, not 67. Saying you add these together first, whatever that is, you take that away from 180, that should give you what that angle is. Okay, so just kind of we put a bit of common sense into equation form. Let's add these together first and take that from 180, that should give us x. It seems to work. Okay, how do we know, how can we double check and make sure 61 is correct? Emma?
Add all the angles together with 61.
Okay, did anybody do that and just double check that it was correct? You're certain that 61 is correct? Okay, all the angles of a triangle should add up to 180. Okay? So let's just see which of these is true by plugging in 61. Okay? So is this true? Is this equation true?
Yeah.
In fact, it almost directly states the property of the sum of the interior angles of the triangle. The angle plus the angle plus the angle should equal 180. So that should be true.
Mm-hmm.
X isn't by itself, but if we were to figure out what x was, it would have to be 61. Is that?
It's true, but it doesn't help you find what x equals.
That's what it
does.
You just did that problem that you couldn't find x.
You couldn't find x?
If you just did that problem, you didn't do anything else.
Well, but that is an equation that x is the solution to, that this 61, right, would make true. Okay, Okay? It's true, if you didn't do anything else, you wouldn't know what x was exactly, but the doing that stuff is what we call solving for x, which is, as long as the equation, if we solved it, gave us the correct value for x, then that's what we're looking for.
The bottom one, it couldn't be right because 62 plus 57 is less than 180, so it'd be a negative number.
We wind up getting a negative number. What negative number would we get, do you think?
Minus 61.
So this would give us negative 61. So, probably something to be done there. We could fix it, but this, as it looks, is not quite right. Okay? So this one's correct. This one works, right? 61 does go in there for x, and it will be true. If I add 61 plus 57 plus 62, that side will be 180. This side will be 180. The equation will be true. All right. How about? Oh, okay. So we all agreed that this one needs to be fixed and made into that one. Okay. So if we add 62 and 57 first, we get that answer, and we subtract that from 180. We've all agreed that that would tell me 61 degrees. What about 180 minus 62 minus 57?
No.
Zach?
That wouldn't work.
Why not?
Because 180, it could work.
Now you do?
I think it can.
You converted yourself?
Yeah.
Can you convert all of us to believing that this?
So 180 minus 62,
mm-hmm.
which would be 118.
Okay.
And then you would do minus 57, which would equal 61.
So whether we add them up first and then subtract, or subtract them one at a time, it's the same thing. In fact, I can turn this equation into this equation with a certain kind of property. I don't know if you're familiar with it. Are you familiar with a property that could turn this into this? What? What property would that be?
I don't know. I don't know.
Is there like crosses it out and
basically
like the
distributive.
Oh, this Ricky Thomas letter.
What are we distributing into the parentheses here, 62 plus 57?
The plus sign.
The plus
sign. The negative.
Negative 1 times that parentheses. Distribute that negative number.
Hello?
All right. So, what we were saying just a second ago was, when I'm talking... Good. Thank you for talking relevant material. Yeah. Distributing. What do we distribute? Distributing the negative one. The whole parentheses being multiply by negative one. We distribute the negative one. We get negative 62. And negative 57. Okay, so we found two that didn't work, and we found three that do work. And in fact, like any of these can be turned into the other ones because they're all the same. They all have the same solution, right? How about if I take this one, 62 plus 57 plus x equals 180. That's just the most basic way to say all the angles add up to 180. Subtract 62. On both sides, you guys do that before? Subtract things from both sides. Subtract 57 from both sides. All right, 62 minus 62 is 0. 57 minus 57 is 0. And x equals, look at that, 180 minus 62 minus 57. That's exactly what this one looks like. 180 minus 62 minus 57. So this is the same equation. When we do that, we get 61. Okay. And now, to write the equation for this one, I mean, I guess you pick whichever style you like the most, and you go that way. Everybody's style is different, right? Card? No? Sarah?
Can't you just like add 62 and 57 and then like,
yes, you can.
Yeah, and then like take it.
Yeah.
Subtract it.
From 180? Yes. That's what this equation says. The answer is yes. It's right there.
Yeah, kind of can see it's yellow.
Yeah. I won't soapbox about that right now. All right, so our book starts us out with solving equations, but I think there are some things that we need to practice first. Okay, so we're going to practice those things today. We're going to practice evaluating expressions and simplifying expressions. Okay, let's start with a pretty simple one, like number two. We have 7x minus x, and I want you to make x be equal to 3. So every x needs to be 3. So 7, I like to use parentheses.
Me too.
All right, 7 times 3 minus 3. And now it's just down to, how do we decide what to do first? But how do we decide it's multiplication?
Oh, that's the way we decided to do it.
That's the way we decided to do it. That order, right? Multiplication is going to come, Aubrey, first, right? What's going to come first? Multiplication. 7 times 3 comes before 3 minus 3. We're not going to do 3 minus 3 first. We're going to do 7 times 3. 21 minus 3, and we get?
18.
Okay, good. Now let's talk about, where did this one come up? Here, number 4. Hey, let's all stop doing this. Also, let's not be mean to people, including ourselves. Okay? Let's see. Well, if you got a wrong answer, okay, then I'd be glad to look over it with you. So what I was trying to do as I came around, and I did help quite a few people, but just can't help everybody all the way, every time. With number 4, we have 7x minus 10x, and I want x to be equal to negative 4. Okay. So this brought up a couple of things that I believe are not new ideas, but just needed to be reminded of things like, well, first we're going to multiply these together, right? Then we'll multiply these together, and then we'll subtract the result. So 7 times a negative 4, that's a positive number times a negative number, which should give us a what?
Negative.
A negative number, okay? Negative 28.
Oh, well, that's
not enough. Now, it depends on how you approach this next thing. We could look at it like 10 times negative 4, that's negative 40. But what are we doing with that negative 40, then?
Subtracting.
We're subtracting it. Okay. Could have done it a little differently. I could have said negative 28, and then said negative 10 times negative 4. What's negative 10 times negative 4?
Negative, or positive, maybe?
Negative times negative is positive, right? Negative 10 times negative 4 is positive 40, so we're adding 40.
Yeah.
Okay, these are equivalent. Let's talk about negative 28 minus negative 40. If we look at a number line, that's 0, then where's negative 28?
Behind.
To the left over here, negative 28. Okay. If I were to subtract, if I started here and I were to subtract from there, what would that look like, Zach?
You go farther to the left.
Go farther to the left. I'm going to subtract the number. What if I was going to add something?
You go to the right.
Okay, go to the right. Now, if I wanted to add a negative number, what would that look like? Yeah?
A negative number to a negative number?
If I want to take negative 28 and I want to add a negative number, what does it look like to add a negative number?
You would count left the amount of spaces you would add to negative 28.
Right. If I were to add a negative number, go to the left. Okay, so we're talking about three things so far. Subtract a number, add a number, add a negative number. How about subtract a negative number?
Go to the right.
Go to the right. Okay, let's think about it like this. If I'm standing here and I've got a notion of negative numbers, everybody have a notion of negative numbers?
Yeah.
Yeah? Like an idea of what it means?
Yeah.
An idea of what a negative number is? Understand what negative numbers are? Okay. Negative numbers are on the left side of zero. They're like, if I owe you money, if I have negative $5, it means I owe somebody $5, right? That's what negative means. So if I was standing here, and I started to walk this direction, okay? I'm gonna walk this direction. And I'm gonna walk this direction, negative 5 feet. How do I walk this direction, negative 5 feet?
Side shuffle.
Go backwards, right? Negative is behind me, okay? If I don't go anywhere, I've gone 0 feet. If I go this way, I've gone positive feet. If I go this way, I'm either subtracting feet or going that way, negative feet, right? Okay? Now if I wanna go forward, positive feet, I would go this way. But if I wanna go this way, well, if I wanna go this way 5 feet, I just go this way 5 feet. But if I want to go this way, I wanna go in this direction, that's the negative direction. I want to go in that direction, a negative 5 feet. Well, if I'm looking that way, then which way would I go negative
that?
That way. That way. Yeah, I go negative this way. It's the opposite of this way. So you get that double negative, okay? So if I want to subtract a negative 40, I actually want to go this direction. How much?
40 times.
40, it's the same as adding 40, which we see here. If you thought of it as a negative times a negative is a positive, right? Negative times negative is positive. So negative 28 plus 40, we can look at it that way, we can look negative 8, negative 28 minus a negative 40, it's the same thing, right? And we wind up with what?
12.
Okay, as long as it's negative times negative, subtracting negatives, those kinds of things that it was clear we needed some refresher on, okay? But next time, I want you to, if you've already done it, maybe you haven't, to evaluate all of these for the given values of x, okay? So you watch out for negatives times negatives, watch out for subtracting negative numbers, just look it over and make sure it's correct before you come back next time.
Can you turn it in?
We won't, yet.
Okay.
So just hold on to it. If you're done, just put it in your notebook and bring it back next time.
Okay.